Do you think they would do well at like during the summer?
I think it would do especially well during the summer. Think of all the children passing by. You'd really have to
Think of the
focus.
children.
Really have to focus on the children, really draw them in. Kids walking around, they're going to McDonald's. I don't want to go to McDonald's. I
Do you
want
have
to
a
go
full-time Santa in the
see,
back?
yes, I want to go see Santa Claus. I was like, what's Santa doing not up at his workshop? Well, he gets hungry too. He flies in. Flies in
He's
for a
got a
while.
restaurant as a sideline business.
Yeah, I think he would have to make appearances just so the kids don't get wise.
But let's say in the middle of summer, can he just wear like red and white shorts and t-shirt?
Yeah.
Okay.
But he must have the beard.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
It's
Oh,
his
we'd have
look.
an on-call Santa. He'd only be Santa for us.
Well, who would he be, on-call Santa, or he'd be full-time Santa?
Well, he would be an on-call Santa, but he could not be Santa for anybody else.
Okay. He
So,
is, yeah, he is our Santa at St.
yeah.
Nick's.
I don't want to go to the mall across the street and see him peddling his wares over there.
No.
Especially
Well,
not in the middle of summer.
what if he just, can he just go to a Radio Shack and buy like an AM FM radio slash flashlight?
What? Why?
It's just because he wants one. He might
Oh,
go camping this summer.
yeah, but he cannot call himself Santa Claus.
Okay.
He cannot use the name Santa, and he can't have children sit on his lap. Normally, that's a rule that transcends Christmas, but I think it would be good. I think the kids would really get in on that,
You
and I
think
would love it.
I have some follow-up questions there, Matthew.
Yes.
So,
I'm picturing the place now, Sebastian. There's just fireplaces everywhere. There's Christmas trees.
but
There's
in the summer, is that not
elves.
just too hot?
Everyone just dressed up as no,
I
because
was
you.
about to say, is the staff all dressed up
No,
as
they're
elves?
dressed up as elves for sure, or like grandmothers. I'm not sure yet. I
Like
don't know what
grandmothers or like
like a
Mrs. Claus?
like an old time fashion, an old family Christmas. You know, I guess it wouldn't make sense to have people dressed up like your immediate family.
Yeah,
So
that's weird. Like,
elves is a little
yeah, the
better.
staff is dressed up like your grandma. Like, why?
That's extra.
Yeah.
No, you'd be pumping the cold in. I think there'd be a vestibule when you walk in, and it's like a walk-in freezer. And that's where you have to wait a few minutes, but for your table to be prepared. And when you walk in, it's the heat from the
The warmth,
fireplaces. So
yes.
you forget what it's like outside. You forget it's summer.
Interesting. Now, could they have like bibs that are ugly Christmas sweater bibs?
This is all sounding perfect. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Great. I think I had one more follow-up question, but I'm forgetting what it is now.
Huh.
What's for dessert?
It's like we're just touching the tip of the iceberg here with these thoughts right now. This is something you really have to mull over a couple of years. But I'm saying, I mean, bowl full of jelly,
Oh, yes. Sugar plums?
sugar plums. I don't know how good a bowl full of jelly would be, but it's on the menu. You don't
Yeah.
have to order it.
Yeah.
Sugar plums, gingerbread man, whole gingerbread house maybe. Yeah.
I remember the follow-up question.
Yes.
Do you have any kind of insurance policy because your staff is listening to Christmas music year-round?
Wait, you're saying it's maddening?
Yeah.
I don't
I
think.
feel like people get frustrated, and I read an article during December how productivity can drop and morale can drop when Christmas music starts at like beginning of November, and you're like 2 months of this. Imagine if it's 12 months of this.
Love it as long as there's enough variation. I don't want to be hearing Little Drummer Boy for 2 months straight, but if I can hear, just Jingle Bell
Bertsy
Rock.
Papa Noel, sung by a chorus of children.
And when it's over, Bitsy
Yeah.
Papa, no, just over and over.
Just that no Christmas tree over and
No, you
over.
just throw. I'd be good if the restaurant just played Mariah Carey.
Okay.
All I Want for Christmas,
Oh
and it was
man.
over and
That's also
over and
maddening.
over. No, you can mix it up though. Really, it's just a magical time. You're not living there, except for the
No.
people who work there. They're
Yes.
kind of living there.
Okay.
I think it would be the staff would rotate quite heavily.
Now, moving on from Christmas, I know we're deep in January now, but we're still talking about Christmas.
I'm talking about Christmas all of 2018.
It's going to be maddening. Last week, I passed by in the forum. There's this little, it was a Halloween store, but then it was temporarily a New Year's store.
Well,
Now I guess they don't, they're waiting for the next holiday to come rolling around.
It was a Halloween store, one of those pop-up like mega Halloween
Yeah.
stores that became a Christmas store that still sold Halloween items right beside like giant candy canes and inflatable Santas. Mm-hmm. There's like, or this X-Men costume. Here's a bunch of wigs for Christmas. And now it's, and then it was a New Year's store.
Yeah.
And now I don't even know, but they're still open. They have not closed yet. No, they didn't get the memo.
They haven't gotten rid of their stock. No. Honestly, I went in there. It was 2018. And I was looking at some of the New Year's stuff. I was like, okay, they got like streamers and stuff. Wait a second. This all says 2017.
Yes.
This is all like 2 year old stuff.
I was in the same boat.
Well, not 2 year old, but like a year and a month old stuff.
Yeah. I was in the same boat as you, but I went New Year's Eve, actually. I was going. And I was like, I got to buy some stuff. It's going to be cheaper because it's New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
Maybe it's the opposite.
So the last chance to sell it.
Yeah, but I'm looking and everything, they have their stickers covering up the little Walmart logo. So it's clear that they got them from Walmart and other places like Winners. And their prices were more expensive than the prices that were covered up.
Mm.
And I almost bought some out of because I was a little desperate. But then like you just noted, 2017. You don't ring in 2017 when you're trying to ring in 2018.
That's funny that you say that because when we first talked about this, that we'd both been to this store, you were like, I was wondering for a second, do you celebrate the year that just ended or the year that's about to begin? No, it is the New Year's Day.
Yeah.
It's not like
Old Year's Day.
Yeah. It's not last year's day.
They should have last year's day followed by New Year's Day.
New Year's Eve should be last year's day.
Yeah.
Last year's last day.
Yeah. Yeah, give it a little credit. You celebrate it with such esteem. Mm-hmm. And then a year goes by and then you just, it was like, oh, moving on, next year. It's like, I don't know, it's like celebrating somebody else's birthday when it's still your birthday.
Yeah, I was going to say it's more like a funeral where instead of like celebrating someone's life, you're like, what's life going to be like now that they're gone?
Yeah, pretty much.
Let's look forward to that. It's going to be different.
It's going to be different. Like, exactly. Everyone always looks at the negative stuff. It's like, I don't know. Do you remember a time in your life when people were like, well, you know, 1998 was such a great year. We're going to be sad to see it leave. But bring on 1999.
No.
Everyone's always like, oh, let's, you know, thank God we made it through this year.
Yeah, it's always like, oh, that year, let's start fresh.
Yeah, let's try to forget everything that happened, and you know, here are all the people we should leave behind in 2017.
That's right.
Here are all the, and it's like, no, just sell it. Don't, I don't know. Everyone's just such a flip flopper.
Can't you just be like, years. What a great year that was?
Yeah.
How could 2018 ever live up?
Yeah. You set 2018
to the lofty
up.
Heights.
Yeah, like raise the bar for 2018. Raise the bar for the following year. Don't set it so low. I don't know, but this
at least it won't be 2017.
Ugh. this little pop-up store set the bar real low.
Yeah, it was also really weird. I was wandering around there. I mean, there were some things that were pretty decent deals. I was looking at some pretty good winter hats that like flop down and cover your ears and stuff.
They were selling $12-$13 there too.
Yeah, well, I feel like maybe they're accessories for Halloween costumes.
Okay,
because they also had like $80 Halloween costumes. I thought, you're getting as far away from Halloween as you can now. We're in January. Like, Halloween's a ways away.
Yeah.
These costumes should be on sale. Sexy Super Mario should not be sold at $80.
Is Sexy Super Mario a men's costume?
No, it's a ladies' costume.
Okay.
There was also regular Super Mario, also $80. Less material.
Still a mustache.
Or more material. Oh,
yeah, more material.
One had a stick-on mustache, and the ladies' version had fingerless gloves and mustache on a stick.
Oh, man, why is that sexy?
I don't know. Well, instead of overalls, it was like a little blue skirt.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
She could, like, hide behind the mustache.
Oh.
Just like, that's weird. But yeah, they should definitely lower the prices.
Yeah.
They're just waiting on that one person who's really desperate.
It's got to be that the rent is so unbelievably low, right?
Low?
Yeah.
No, the rent in that place is so unbelievably high.
Really?
Yeah.
How can they run a Halloween store in January with high rent?
I don't know.
Who's going in there buying fake mustaches in January?
It must be someone's like cousin or something. Because I always used to think they're kicking people out of this place because they can't afford the rent. And they're just like, can't afford. No, but
the
like,
old
that's the
tenants
thing.
Built a new store.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what are you talking about?
The one we're talking about.
Yeah.
It was the SAQ in there before.
Yeah, the SAQ. And they left.
And they have a new building across the street now.
They warned them that they would. So,
you know the inside scoop.
We're getting into some inside, but they were there was a battle going on for a couple of months. It's like, we are not going to renew the lease if you don't give us like two parking spaces. We want two parking spaces for our like employees to be able to park. And it's like, no. Underground parking at the forum is too good.
Okay.
And so they let them leave. That was really? That was that thing. And then they bring in, but I'm thinking for some of the other places, like some of the restaurants that they had in there, rent just wasn't, the rent was so high they had trouble paying it.
Okay.
And so I think they were late a few times, kick them out. But you kick them out and you don't replace them with anything?
Yeah, you're just losing money. Yeah.
Like lower the rent so that people, so that can it's afford always it. Full.
Yeah.
And once it's full, you can start raising the rent. If anybody starts dipping out, you could maybe find people
stop
to come
there,
in.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I don't know. I don't understand how they let this place stay open. Because I don't think they're making any money.
They got to be giving them, because a place like a Halloween store, it's so temporary, right?
Yeah.
They got to be giving them such low rent, being like, oh, you're just temporary. So here's super low rent. And they're like, well, let's hang on to this spot. This is a sweet spot. We can sell some sparkly hats for the new year.
Yeah, they're just like, sell off your inventory. And it's like, oh, they don't know how much inventory we have.
We have so much inventory. So many Cupid arrows now.
Yeah, it's like, oh, and
Valentine's is coming.
Well, they'll sell all their Valentine's Day stuff after Valentine's Day when they run over to Walmart,
exactly.
Buy it all for dirt cheap, and then try to sell it next year.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Speaking of stores that shouldn't still be open, we went to a video store this evening, Sebastian.
That's right. After we left Confortable, we passed by a video store that... Honestly, I've walked past a dozen times, but I've never really noticed.
Yeah.
There's a pawn shop like three storefronts down from there that I notice every time.
Yeah.
And somehow I never noticed this place.
Yeah.
So as we were going to the restaurant, you were like, oh, video store. I was like, yeah, let's come back here later. And so we did. Matthew, you love video stores. You basically volunteered for years at a video store. You want to tell me your first impressions when you walked into this blast from the past?
Yeah, this was a real video store. It wasn't like, they still have some Videotrons out there, but a lot of them have converted themselves into, you know, half videos, and the rest is like try to sell you a cell phone when you walk in.
Yeah, yeah, a cell phone or a cable package or internet, what have you.
Yeah, and they still sell those like laminated on wood, you know, Scarface posters and stuff.
Scarface posters got to be one of the best selling all time posters.
Well, that's
right?
Why they made the movie.
Yeah, just as a vehicle to move some posters.
Exactly. But this place didn't really have any of that. It was just, it had like a little freezer that would sell popsicles that was unplugged. And not working, but it was still out.
I didn't notice. I didn't look in there.
There was a bunch of like old games, like just like old, like, you know, put a toonie in here, some gumball machines, all the stuff that was left over from the 80s and the 90s. And it looked like it had been a lot bigger. There was a basement that was blocked off. There was a little
gate. Oh, there was another floor?
There was another floor, but that was like management only. But I imagine at some point that would make a pretty good arcade.
Oh, wow.
But they just had the artwork all over the walls.
Yeah. They had like
Sonic, Spider-Man.
Like people had painted movies, like character. Wow, I can't speak. People had painted characters from movies and video games up on the wall. Huge portrait of Spider-Man, Sonic the Hedgehog, and then the edges, sort of the end caps, I guess, of shelves of videos had like Super Mario or Donkey Kong, which I imagine in the day would have had like old Nintendo games or something on them.
Yeah.
And they had like, you know, action heroes and stuff painted on it. Like this place got a lot of love in its heyday.
Yeah. And too much love even now. There were three employees and we were the only people there.
We were there for a good half hour. There were more employees than customers. One employee, it looked like he was just sort of shuffling boxes around.
Yeah.
One not clearly doing anything at all. And one mopping up after the no customers.
Yeah. We chose that one spot to really like
to really stand,
because that's where we want to look. But yeah, I just, it was like a blast from the past, maybe to when video stores were starting to die off, because they were selling a bunch of like Sega Genesis games.
Some old like original Sega Genesis games.
Yeah, but like out where it's like in the bin in the middle of the store, not like off to the side. This is like the thing you walk right up to. And I was like, they're still selling Sega games?
Yeah, and that's what really caught my attention. So we walked in, I'm looking. Yeah. They got some DVDs. They got some new video games. And you say, they got Sega Genesis games? And then the next 25 minutes was spent with me looking at old video